Some of the visitors to our forum have often expressed their interest in us reviewing some of the more classic or forgotten games. The ones that are underrated then, and are underrated today. For the people who have expressed this interest, you guys couldn't have picked a better area for VMTV to explore. It gives you a sense of joy to look up at the screen and go, wow, I can't believe they remember this game, that's awesome. Believe me, we've gotten a lot of comments about that. Take a look at the Sin and Punishment review that Matt did back in episode 6. We got a lot of good feedback about that. People can't believe we actually took a look at that game. Now, the game we're going to be looking at today may not be as well known or respected or appreciated or whatever. It's for the Turbografx-16 system. It's called Cybercore, and I'm not going to waste any more of your time having you look at my mug. Here's the review. We all know aerial fighters were coming out the ass during the 80s and 90s. Many of them quite good, but after some time, there's got to be something done to the formula. That's where Cybercore comes in. In this game, you pilot the ship called the Chimera. I think that's how it's pronounced. I don't know. It appears to be just an ordinary fighter plane. However, this piece of hardware has the ability to grow and morph into some sweet-ass machinery with some heavy firepower. This process takes place when you shoot this flying green bug. With each shot, he'll poop out some capsules. These colored suppositories will not only alter the look of your ship, but upgrade your weapons as well. As you can well imagine, this aerial fighting game will not have you shoot down other aircraft. Your primary enemies are bugs. Lots of them. Other enemies consist of plants and mushrooms. Might have been what was smoked during this game's conception. Funky as it is, it's not all terrible. The idea that you can grab power capsules to upgrade your ship is actually kind of cool. The story is standard. Bugs invade Earth. You are called to spray 8 levels with your own brand of pesticide. Blah, blah, blah. The hero is actually named Rad Ralph. And if that's him, I think he too has been hitting the shrooms. Alright, let's talk about the graphics first. It's 16-bit, it's nice and colorful, oftentimes you'll be looking at a combination of organic and mechanical landscapes. It's good enough for its time. The music, while appropriate for some levels, isn't anything special. And no, I wasn't expecting to have this full symphony orchestra. I wasn't quite sure what I was expecting first going into this game. All I can say is the music is pretty average, and the sound effects are about the same. With the press of the select button, you can increase or decrease the speed of your ship. A very unique feature, but it can get you killed faster, so unless you're really skilled, you're not going to be whizzing back and forth so quickly, especially in the later levels where the enemies are a bit faster and their flight pattern is harder to memorize. Yes, just about all these enemies, including the big-ass boss characters, do have a pattern to them. This bugger, for example, I mean look, all I had to do was stay to the left of the screen and wait for him to do his little pattern thing and get to the top of the screen and then I blast away like so. It won't take that long to find a strategy to your enemies, and once you reach level 8, damn. Don't even have time to breathe or grab those damn suppositories that the bug keeps pooping out. Cybercore overall is a meh, try it. Emphasis on the meh.